Hi, and welcome to part 3 of my Carbot series. In the last episode, I discussed making wheels. In this episode, I will show the chassis design. I also learned a lot from building this Mark 1 chassis. The cardstock is just not stiff enough to handle the torque and power of the stepper motors. I applied stiffeners to the cardstock, but it was not enough. I considered laminating the cardstock, but was convinced this would not solve the problem. I ultimately built a box out of wooden stir sticks. Thanks for letting me raid your craft supplies, sweetie, providing a much stiffer structure for mounting the stepper motors. I tried making a wheel for the back end, but it ended up skidding most of the time. Wheels, apparently, are hard to make. I settled for a hook skid that seems to be working okay. There were some weak points in the Mark 1 stepper motor mount, so I decided to take what I learned and designed the Mark 2 chassis. It is much stiffer and stronger than the Mark 1 chassis. I'm calling this the assembly drawing because it shows how everything goes together. You can see the holes on the side for stepper motor mounting, and here you see the cutouts for the steppers. I also created a fab drawing for fabricating all the parts. The lines will help with placement of the wooden parts. I'm not crazy about using 3D text for labels, but haven't found a better way yet. Here are the paper templates and all the parts ready for assembly. Alright, I tried to do, or decided to do one of those speed up video things, so this is going at 16 times normal speed, so you won't have to suffer through it for very long, but it'll just give you kind of the basic idea of the overall assembly, and as you can see, it doesn't require a great amount of skill or any kind of fancy tools or anything, a hot melt glue gun or a I suppose if you had the patience, you could assemble this with Elmer's glue, although you'd have to hold things or figure out some way to clamp it together while the glue cures. But as you can see, most of the parts fit the first time. Some of them had to be trimmed down a little bit. Gotta watch out for putting your fingers in hot glue. That's never pleasant, and of course it makes the little cobwebs of upmelt glue that you have to deal with later. Those are my Achilles heel, I guess, those darn spider webs. Moving on to final assembly. The stepper motors are mounted. And yes, I used hot melt glue to dress the wires. A look at the underside, the front. Yes, I love my hot melt glue. Here I used it to join the individual jumper wire pins for easier connection to the driver board and Arduino. The Arduino and prototype shield are mounted. I also find hook and loop fastener convenient. The tail hook design, disregard the double image. And finally, with the wheels on. This battery pack is a little heavy. I really need to get something lighter. Perhaps a lithium polymer pack. Coming up in part 4, Gettin Sketchy. Thanks for watching.